Right, so Shumi and me are on.
Why is this the inside?
Anyway, leave aside. But Shumi and me are on today to discuss the budget. Right, so Shumi and me are on today to discuss the budget, and there have been some very startling revelations. Duties have increased on luxury cars and luxury motorcycles.
Look, I wasn't here when the budget was being.
Yeah, so
first tell me what happened in the budget.
That's what I'm coming to now. Excise duty on SUVs has been increased from 30% to 30% from 27%.
Okay.
SUVs registered as taxis exempted.
Okay, so 3% rise on non-taxi SUVs.
Yeah, that's one. Import duty on luxury products has luxury import on luxury vehicles has been increased from 75% to 100%.
25% increase.
Yeah, so 70% to 70% to 30%.
You watched the budget or not?
I did watch the budget. 70% to 30%. A lot been going otherwise also. And on import motorcycles, which is your domain basically, that has gone up from 50% to 65%.
15% increase.
15%.
Okay, fine. So then right. What? Mehngai ka zamana yaar.
I'm still far away. I'm still getting the numbers, man. Okay, but
He's like this one.
We will do this again. One second.
No, it's going really well. We will not re-record this video. It's fine, right?
So, we're going to have to wait for this in any case, but, so it's not a good, it's basically not good news for anyone. There's a 25% hike in CBU cars and 15% hike in import duties for import motorcycles. Not very good news in terms of premium cars and premium
in
motorcycles.
Terms of, yeah, the enthusiasm.
Essentially, the volumes market is not affected by this in a significant manner, except for... the excise duty on the SUVs thing, and I'm not very happy. I'm not very pleased with that because
fair enough. But what I'm seeing this is that the finance minister has decided that the enthusiast, the leisure automobile enthusiast, has to be penalized for his.
Well, there's nothing. Enthusiast bitched about it. Just having premium cars or whatever.
Yeah, I understand that, but you know exactly what I mean, right? So the upper end of the automotive industry is. Supposed to pay more. The SUV guy is supposed to pay more.
Yeah.
But what has he done to promote the lower end of the industry is what I'm interested in. I know, inflation is at 10-ish% anyway, so everything is going up, becoming more expensive by 10%. So if the finance minister raises prices by 15% here and there, it's not really night and day. But what has he done to promote the mass market? What has he done for cheap motorcycles and cheap cars?
Well, that's what, there's no benefits for the consumer in the end. Enthusiasm and all that is, let's keep them aside. Bare basic market, there is absolutely nothing given to the consumer, or there's nothing given to the automotive industry to boost sales or to get them up from the negative growth that we've already seen. No one's buying cars, no one's buying bikes in any case.
Mm-hmm.
And there is nothing given to that that segment which will basically get them into positive growth. So, what are essentially...
Has he at least reduced, say, for example, income taxes so I can afford to buy more cars?
Not really. There's nothing even out there. That's it. Like I said, there's not a lot more in disposable income going to come into people's hands to buy more cars or bikes or anything of that matter.
Mm.
There's nothing so far revealed on what the interest rates will be for these products.
Okay.
Such. Whether cars and whether on or your interest duty, the interests on loans will probably reduce. Or like I said, there is nothing done to encourage growth of the automotive sector at all. It is only natural that we look at all the negative aspects that happen in all of this.
Mm.
But yeah, on the large, I don't see much that's positive otherwise. I didn't like the finance minister mentioning that SUVs occupy a lot of space on the road. The SUVs probably constitute less than 1% of the total, automotive sales in India for that matter. Less than 1%. That's nothing.
What is it he drives in?
I'm sure that's an SUV.
Okay, no, but wait. Let's be serious for a minute.
But again, forget about his personal choices and whatever it is.
I just think
it is wrong to tax the SUV segment specifically. To target the SUV segment. It's like
is that because
it's like saying because you're a celebrity, I'm going to tax you. Because you're in the public eye.
You have a soft spot for the SUVs, don't you?
I don't have a soft spot for SUVs as such. I'd rather prefer sports cars or something like that. Sorry.
But that also is raised taxes on, right?
I do like SUVs, yes, because it gives me a lot more freedom and allows me to go places where I want to go and all that stuff. But besides the point, it can't just be targeting a single segment of
sure.
the entire industry. I can understand that you say, you know, it's everything above 10 lakhs or anything about 20 lakhs or anything above 50 lakhs. But just saying only the SUVs, I'm going to target only this and increase duties on that. I don't think that's done. That's not the right way to do it at all.
Okay.
Because essentially, what we're not realizing is that with the hike in excise duty, and that's a 30% hike, this will also affect homegrown manufacturers
sure.
like Mahindra. Ford, for instance, which is coming up with the EcoSport now,
sure.
you know, that will be a massive challenge for them. Now, I suspect Ford will probably do an introductory pricing.
Mm-hmm.
So the first 2 weeks, 3 weeks, or probably a month, they will take the hit
mm-hmm.
from whatever is there. But after that, they will raise prices and it will go up significantly.
Sure.
So yeah, the ones who have escaped that radar and gone under the radar now are Honda, who've got away with the CR-V. But again, CR-V also prices will increase.
Yeah, no.
So initially, if someone
yeah.
did you know pick up a CR-V, then they benefited from the price. As well, but the CRV prices also will increase.
Right. Now, and the other part of it is that sometimes they say that having very high import duties on imported cars and motorcycles is beneficial to the domestic market because, well, it raises the bar for imports and therefore international manufacturers have to think very seriously about investing, making plants here and giving jobs to people and upgrading skills and all that technology.
But it doesn't really change that scenario because...
Yeah, but if you raise taxes by these small percentages, then it's just profiteering, effectively. I mean, you're just trying to make more money
from these... There's a lot of debate going on, we're seeing a lot of debate on... We're seeing a lot of debate on social media about how manufacturing will now happen and localization will happen for all these high-end SUVs and all that, which is not possible because for manufacturers, they still constitute less than 1% of the market of the total automotive or total car sales. It really does not justify it for a manufacturer to put that kind of investment into localizing SUVs. If that had to happen, this would have happened probably about 5 years ago
okay.
when duties, you know, were on the higher side in any case. So it had to happen, it had happened then. Over the last 2 or 3 years, duties had dropped down, but they've not been raised again. So it's not exactly a scenario where manufacturers want to come back into the whole, let me localize my products.
They had
done it 5 years ago.
No, or you should have raised the tax
exactly.
saying, boss, here it is, everything is 100% more expensive now.
Exactly.
So you now pay 240% on imports.
Is there a benefit that says, you know, by localizing your production, you will get some excise duty cuts or anything
else?
Nothing of that sort.
And all SUVs are taxed. I mean, whether you make them here or import
exactly.
them is how I understand it. Look, I was asleep through most of the budget. That just broken up. But how I understand it is all SUVs get taxed, which is just not very good for SUVs. So,
effectively, the lesson to be taken home from this is that the industry is not going to grow in 2013. And despite me writing in a column and being very optimistic about it and saying that, yes, things will get better and, you know, hopefully let's keep our fingers crossed and things will look brighter, I don't see that happening any longer. So... Yes, while I have been speculative about optimistic about things going forward, I don't think it's going to happen anymore. Probably my next column is not going to be as optimistic as the last one.
Yeah, I think what it basically means is it's time to order pizza because pizza has statistically been shown to cheer up people.
Yeah, well, not anymore. If you order from an air-conditioned restaurant, you're probably going to pay more because that's another bit that's been taxed. So yes, not everything is very, very hunky-dory as we like to think it is, but... Anyway, now the biggest losers or the people who will actually stand a lot to lose in this, of course, is BMW, Audi, Mercedes and Porsche. Porsche, of course, a large part of their sales comes from the Cayenne. It's the mainstay. So, yes, that will get hit adversely. Mahindra will get affected. Mahindra will get affected because a large part of their portfolio has to do with SUVs alone. Of course, it may probably force Mahindra to look at the sedan and the hatchback. I mean, you know now the Verito hatch is coming out very shortly. So it'll focus their attentions on the car side of the business. Now Ford is coming out with the EcoSport very shortly and yes, that will be affected. Probably Ford might decide to take a hit initially and to create the buzz in the market, they might sort of still launch the EcoSport at fairly reasonable, very competitive prices and then hike it up later. But these are the ones who stand a lot to lose in this current market, in the SUV segment.
Yeah, now just to
in the motorcycle segment,
discuss
the
imported motorcycles, all six of them that sell every year are going to be more expensive. Well, okay, no, let's be serious. If you're serious, Harley-Davidson, whatever they import, their prices will go up by a small amount and I don't think it will really affect their sales curve. People who are going to buy those bikes are still going to buy those bikes. On the other side, Yamaha, Suzuki, Honda, all of these guys sell very, very small numbers of imported motorcycles. So it's not really a crisis. Bajaj has so far not committed to either Kawasaki or KTM imports, so it doesn't change anything there. And Triumph is so far a no-show in the business. So yes, if Triumph comes, their prices will be more expensive than planned. But when Triumph will come, nobody seems to know. So in the motorcycle market, I don't think there is any significant negative impact. It's not a good thing, yes, but is there a negative impact? Not really. Does it actually help motorcycles sell more? Unfortunately, no.
Well, interestingly, when I said the excise duty for non-taxi SUVs has gone up. So I'm not entirely clear what this non-taxi SUV business is because, not a lot of people use SUVs for taxis in any case, are registered as taxis. A lot of the taxi registrations happen for MUVs. So there's not a lot of
Finance minister know the difference between the Innova
and
the Fortuner?
I'm not sure whether the finance minister knows what the difference between the Innova, the Fortuner is for that matter, or between the Quanto and the Xylo. So yeah, I would say he's not aware of that. So it's probably worded wrongly.
So if I buy a Fortuner and registered a taxi, I will pay more now?
You will pay more for the Fortuner per se, but if it's a taxi, registered as a taxi, you will pay... Probably pay the same as whatever it was before or whatever.
So am I being encouraged to drive around in yellow plated?
Essentially, yes, that's what it says. So what he's going to try and do and encourage is a lot of Ford EcoSports have probably come with yellow plates now.
I saw
Same with the Range Rovers. The only ones to benefit out of this is the Tata Group. Because, of course, they've got Range Rover under their belt, Land Rover under their belt, and they also got the change of hotels.
And SUVs.
The Taj Group. A lot more SUVs running as chauffeur-driven hotel taxis. So that will happen from Jaguars, from seeing XJs and XFs in the Taj Group hotels. You'll now probably see Land Rovers and Discoveries and, of course, the Range Rover. That's most likely to happen.
Good buddy. Anyway, thank you. See you. Good night.
See you.
Have pizza.